Ladies and gentlemen, it's now my privilege to introduce the world-renowned Swedish tenor, star of Metropolitan Opera, Mr. Jussi Björling.
Good evening, Edgar. Good evening, Charlie.
Good evening. It's what, Charlie Graham?
Huh? Make your speech.
Oh, yes, yes. You can you say your treffat, you see, Björling. Välkommen, välkommen.
Thank you. But, Charlie, I didn't know that you spoke Swedish.
Well, I didn't know it either. I gotta watch that, Bergen. He's sneaky.
Mr. Björling, Charlie should know the language. When we played Stockholm 3 years ago, he picked up a little Swedish.
Yes, I did, and she was lovely.
Yes, we do have lovely girls in Sweden.
Uh-huh. You have an eye for beautiful girls?
Just an eye, Charlie. I'm married.
And your wife has an eye on you.
Yes, so it is.
Yeah, so it is.
Yep. Charlie, I think you should show more respect for Mr. Björling. Remember, although we played it to 11,000 people in Stockholm, it was Mr. Björling who broke our record. After all, he's the idol of Sweden.
Björling and Bergen, what a pair. The idol of Sweden and the idol Swede.
No, no. I think I'd better sing while the little rascal is still on my side.
Well, maybe you're right. Ladies and gentlemen, for his first selection tonight, Jussi Björling has chosen the ever-popular Neapolitan love song.
He's leaning and the sun is at rest, the shadows now fall in the heavens. Star is shining, and softly as the sun drop his table mantle o'er, there's a nightingale singing of his love for our own. Madly my heart is beating as I your embrace of your same sweet one, how my heart is yearning ever.
Jussi Björling, bravo! Or as we say in Swedish, lutfisk? No, I mean toxamicki.
Yeah, that's better. Please, Charlie, that was beautifully done, Mr. Björling.
Excuse me, gentlemen. May I interrupt?
Why, yes, little lady. Yes. And you are a lovely interruption, too.
I would like to speak to Mr. Björling.
Well, I'm sorry. Mr. Björling is much too busy right now to give autographs.
But you see...
You silly, silly girl, you. Probably have a crush on him, huh?
As a matter of fact, I do.
I could tell. Well, get ready for a blow. Mr. Björling is married.
No, you get ready for a blow. I married him.
Oh. All right, Bergen, say something. Just don't let me sit here with your mouth open.
I would like to introduce my wife, Annalisa Björling.
Mrs. Björling is the leading soprano of the Royal Opera Company in Stockholm. And later on in the program, she will sing a duet with her husband.
Good.
I almost missed the show tonight. I've been busy all day interviewing managers for our concert tour.
Manager? That sounds like a good job. What are the qualifications?
Well, our manager must be someone who is capable, reliable, and honest.
Capable, reliable, and honest. Would you settle for 2 out of 3?
Not you, Charlie.
Why?
A manager must handle all transportation details.
Well, I'm your boy. I'll work without a salary.
Oh, but that will be taking advantage of you. How would you make any money?
Well, by taking advantage of the Björlings.